Concorde, a byword for luxury travel. But on the 25th of July 2000, flight 4590 bound for New York left the runway of Charles de Gaulle Airport already alight. A minute after takeoff, it crashed in the outskirts of Paris, killing 109 passengers and crew on board, mostly Germans, and four people on the ground. The air accident investigators concluded that a small strip of titanium metal that had fallen onto the runway from a Continental DC-10 set off a catastrophic chain of events, shredding Concorde's tyres as it roared down the runway, sending debris into the fuel tanks, which then caught fire. As in the first judgment, the appeal court agreed that the metallic strip had played some part, but in clearing Continental of criminal responsibility, their ruling refers to other unknown elements.
Après 12 ans, plus de 12 ans.
After 12 years, more than 12 years, Continental has been accused of being responsible for Concorde's accident. Justice has finally been served. Continental is not responsible for the Concorde crash.
But Continental's mechanic, John Taylor, who fitted that titanium strip, was deemed to be negligent, though he could not have known or predicted, said the judges, the events that would follow, which is why his 15-month suspended sentence was quashed. Lawyers for the defence have argued Concorde should have been grounded years before the accident. It was fragile, they said. There had been incidents involving Concorde's tyres that raised concerns, and witnesses were called to back claims it was already on fire before it hit the titanium strip.
We feel totally powerless. They said this plane should not have been allowed to fly. It did fly, and we don't have any answers. What does this mean for air safety?
While Continental has been exonerated of criminal responsibility, under civil law, the appeal judges ordered the company to pay €1 million in damages to Concorde's operator, Air France. There's also a tribunal case pending, in which Air France and its insurers are suing for loss of earnings. Today's ruling could have expensive implications. Christian Fraser, BBC News, Paris.